Imagine a world where AI begins teaching itself skills it was never trained to learn. That reality may be closer than you think. Recently, one of OpenAI's gaming bots played against the world champions in a multiplayer battle arena game, a classic nightmare scenario for any AI, and learned a completely new skill by itself. Is AI starting to become fully autonomous? What will the future look like when AI no longer depends on human interaction to teach itself new things? Stay tuned until the end to find out. OpenAI Five is an AI model designed to play Dota 2, a multiplayer online battle arena game with a huge cult following. To become a pro Dota 2 gamer, you must have a deep understanding of different characters and heroes, excellent communication with teammates, and a solid knowledge of very complex battle strategies. This is why a complex live battle game like Dota 2 is an ideal environment for testing and developing AI, mainly because it's difficult to predict the game's outcomes based on the massive number of possible actions, and the AI doesn't have time to think between moves since the game is not turn-based. In the past, AI had done pretty well playing against pros in games in which the computer had enough time between moves to rethink its strategy and slowly find ways to beat humans, such as chess and checkers. Just think back to when IBM's supercomputer named Deep Blue defeated the world chess champion Garry Kasparov for the first time in 1997. But in games that aren't turn-based and that require a complex combination of long-term strategy, teamwork, mechanical skill, and situational awareness, AI has always been a step behind the best pros in the world. But OpenAI decided to change that. In 2017, OpenAI developed an initial version of OpenAI 5 that could play 1v1 Dota 2 games using only one hero, and although it was a great achievement for it to beat one of the world champions, this didn't really mean that the AI was better at Dota 2 than humans. In fact, 1 year later, when OpenAI 5 challenged other Dota 2 pros to games with a limited hero pool, the AI still consistently lost and showed that it was not yet at the level of world-class players. The reason for this is that it's incredibly difficult to train an AI model to get good at such a complicated game. OpenAI trained its AI model on Dota 2 through deep reinforcement learning, which, in simpler terms, is kind of like training a dog. Good actions get rewarded, bad ones get punished, and over time, the dog, or in this case, the AI, figures out how to maximize rewards. But keep in mind that the AI doesn't read or see the game in the same way that a human looks at the images on screen and processes them to make the best decisions. OpenAI 5 sees the world through the lens of its general-purpose learning code, which means that all it sees is a bunch of numbers that it has to decipher to understand the current state of the game and then find the best ways to increase its own winning probabilities. Once the AI model is trained on enough real-game situations, it can play the game like a pro. Well, at least that's the idea. But training OpenAI 5 to be the very best in the world at their own game is much easier said than done, as it requires training the model on millions and millions of real-game situations so that it knows exactly what to do in each one. The research team at OpenAI really had their work cut out for them, but they only had one mission in mind: to get OpenAI 5 to beat OG, the best Dota 2 team in the world. The last games that OpenAI 5 had played against humans took place in international events, which meant that OpenAI had very little time to train their AI model before sending it to compete against the best in the world. To level the playing field, this time OpenAI set the date for the challenge, which meant that they would have more than enough time to train the model, and let's just say that they used that time wisely. In the last game that the AI had played and lost with a limited hero pool against Dota 2 pros, OpenAI 5 had been trained on about 10,000 years of Dota 2 gameplay over the course of 1.5 months. But in the 10 months following the last game, the model experienced about 45,000 years of Dota self-play for an average of 250 years of simulated experience per day. That's like playing Dota 2 for 24 hours a day for 250 years straight, and then cramming all of that experience into a single day. Can you see how this makes the model incredibly powerful? And after training against itself millions and millions of times, it was time for OpenAI 5 to prove itself against reigning champs, OG, in a best out of three challenge. Surprisingly, OpenAI 5 estimated its win probability to be about 67% after it picked its roster of heroes, and we say surprisingly because during the first few minutes of the game, it almost seemed like the AI bots were playing without a strategy, running around aimlessly and randomly resurrecting their heroes at times when a human pro would probably think it's a mistake to do so. But a few minutes later, it became clear that the AI bots knew exactly what they were doing all along. By playing very aggressively from the start of the game, the bots increased their chances of winning quickly. A few minutes into the game, the bot gave an updated prediction, claiming that its win probability was now 95%. Of course, if you're going to talk trash, you have to walk the talk, and at that point in the game, OpenAI 5 actually seemed to be a bit behind the world champs, but that didn't last for long. Seconds later, the AI turned the game around completely after a series of powerful plays and then gave a shocking update. It now had a 99% chance of winning the game. Sure enough, OpenAI 5 crushed the world champions immediately after.
Sniped down, Notel, right up to the high ground, the Death Robot has the Yule Scepter controlling Anna.
After game one, one thing that stood out to the audience was that the AI seems to know exactly when to engage in battle and when to back away when the hero's health is dangerously low. Almost every single time that the AI engaged in combat with the human players, the AI won the engagement, which was probably intimidating for the OG team as they headed into game two. This time, however, after each team chose its roster, the AI estimated that it had a 60% chance of winning. But things took an unexpected turn pretty quickly. Just 5 minutes into the game and after a very aggressive opening, the AI gave an updated prediction, claiming that its win probability was about 80%. Talk about taunting. In this heated start to game two, you can see many examples of the AI engaging in battle and then backing out quickly when a hero's health is too low, strategically dealing damage to its human opponents, making it very difficult for the human team to go in for the kill.
From the Sven, holds back the Shaker, and he TPs out on 30 HP. OpenAI gets out of there with the Sven.
Just 9.5 minutes into the game, the AI confidently boasted that its chances of winning were once again around 95%, and just 10 minutes later, the game was over. The champs had been dethroned. In this game, the AI's strategy became even more obvious. Because human players have a strategic advantage as the game goes on thanks to their carefully picked roster, the AI's best bet is to never let them reach the endgame and play hyper-aggressively from the beginning, which is exactly how they beat OG 2-0. In a post-game interview, one of the players on the OG team said that they learned a lot from the AI's play, and that it organized its heroes more strategically in a 5v5 game than any human team they had ever played against. He also claimed that if they had played 5 games against the AI, they would have probably won at least one, and after 15 games, they would start winning consistently, but he admitted that eventually AI will become invincible in games like Dota 2 if it's trained on enough data. Later, OpenAI allowed amateur and pro players alike to sign up to play in an online arena to continue testing OpenAI 5's capabilities, and the results were shocking. After 15,000 online games, the AI had a 99% win rate against human players, but the most interesting part was that in one of the game modes, players had the option to play against other human players using AI bots as teammates. After thousands of games, many players reported the same thing happening. The AI was a much better teammate than any other human player ever was. The crazy thing about this is, the AI was never taught to be a teammate. It was only taught to fight against humans and other bots, meaning that the AI turned itself from a competitive bot to a cooperative one. This is extremely exciting for the future of human and AI interaction, as it shows that a future where AI enhances human experience across a wide variety of industries is a very real possibility. Interestingly, the skills that OpenAI 5 learned from playing Dota 2 are not limited to the gaming world. OpenAI applied the same algorithm used for OpenAI 5 to control a robotic hand, demonstrating the versatility of its model and suggesting that many other fields could benefit from an AI model as adaptable as OpenAI 5. Human and AI collaboration has come a long way, and OpenAI 5 has added an exciting chapter to that journey. From here, the possibilities for humans to work with AI to improve our quality of life are limitless. As AI continues to evolve in gaming and beyond, only one thing is certain: we're in for an exciting ride.